Hello, everybody.
Welcome to the Night of Sea of Lives channel. I am here today to say yay! I'm so stoked. Bit of a story. This is the Spyderco Native 5 with the fluted titanium handles I bought, I don't know, around February this year. And I had it for a little while, and I was at work, getting off work, and I put it in my coat pocket. Got in my van, drove over to my sister-in-law's house to pick up my boy. And when I left there, I noticed that, or before I left there, I noticed that it wasn't in my pocket anymore. I was like, oh man, you know, just kind of had that sinking feeling. Anytime I lose one of my knives, which is not very often. But I looked around, fished around on the couch, couldn't really get my hand down in there too much. It's got those reclining seats, or those reclining footrests or whatever that pop up on it. But, I mean, I dug around in there pretty good, couldn't find it. Went back down to work and looked around the parking lot to see, you know, where I parked and at the store. Couldn't find it anywhere. And this thing's been lost for like 6 months. And I've just had this gut feeling all this time that it had to be in that couch. Because, you know, it was in my pocket when I left work. You know, got in my van. I searched my van high and low. Cleaned it out. Couldn't find it. And then I sat in that couch. And, yeah, I just had this feeling. So I took a magnet with me over there today and asked her if I could fish around on her couch with it to see if I could try to find this knife. And she humored me. She was very nice about it. Let me check around in there. No, couldn't find it. So she asked me if, well, do you want to lift up the couch and see if we can find it underneath? I was like, yeah, sure. So I lifted it up, and she got under there and looked, and guess what she found? And it's actually kind of funny, because not only did she find this, but she actually found my lighter that I apparently had lost at some point or another. I mean, it's nothing fancy, but I just thought it was kind of ironic that both it and this knife were underneath the same couch. Apparently, I better make sure that I get button closed pockets when I sit on people's couches or something. But anyway, just really glad to have that back because, man, this thing cuts like crazy. I've used it for a lot of stuff. I used it for scraping carbon buildup off of a burner. I've used it for cutting up cardboard and rubber hoses and, you know, just all kinds of stuff. And it's just a really nicely made knife. There's no gaps at all down the back of it. You know, the handles are nicely done. It just functions nicely. In fact, the finger choil is really comfortable on this one. And that's usually not my observation when it comes to any finger choils that I've noticed on most knives. But that's pretty cool. I really like this knife quite a bit, and it was my only remaining sample of the CPM S35VN as well. So, and I do prefer lockbacks, so that was kind of one of the major things that drew me to this design in the first place. The lockback, the steel type, and the fact that this thing had titanium handles was just an added bonus, because I could have gone a lot cheaper, actually, and got the G10 version, and then I thought, you know, if I'm going to buy this knife, I'll buy the one that I'd like to have the most, and this is it. So, and there it is. I've got it back, and I'm super stoked. But anyway, just thought I'd show you that. There's my other couple of premium Spydercos. They're all pretty premium knives, if you ask me, but there you have them. Thanks for watching, and I'll keep trying to pump out videos every week if I can. If I can't, you have to bear with me. So, leave some comments below. Thanks for watching.